To get started monitoring your lake, you'll first need to gather your equipment. A detailed list is included in the training manual you received from the Minnesota Pollution Control Agency. Be sure that you have everything on hand before you head out for your first monitoring trip. For that trip, it works best if you have a boat that is 14 feet long or larger. It should also have a motor that is properly matched to the boat. A pontoon boat also is a great platform from which to take your measurements, but it can be harder to anchor in windy conditions. Once you've gathered all your equipment, you're ready to head to your sampling location. After you get to your sampling location, the first thing you want to do is record the physical condition and the recreational suitability of the lake. This information is meant to be your personal view of the lake, so you want to do it before you start any monitoring that could influence your opinion. To record the physical condition of the lake, rank it on a scale from 1 to 5. 1 is crystal clear water. 2 is not quite crystal clear, with a little algae. 3 is definite algae of green, yellow, or brown color. 4 is high amounts of algae that limit clarity and possibly create a mild odor. 5 is severe levels of algae with massive floating scum on the lake or shore and a strong, foul odor. After recording the physical condition, look at the lake again and consider its recreational suitability. Again, you'll use a 1-5 scale to rank the lake based on local standards. 1 is beautiful. It couldn't be better. 2 is minor aesthetic or appearance problems, but still excellent for swimming and boating. 3 is swimming and appearance are slightly impaired by algae levels. 4 is reduced swimming and enjoyment because of substantial algae levels. Or, in other words, you would not swim, but boating is still okay. 5 is recreation and enjoyment of the lake's appearance is nearly impossible because of the levels of algae. In other words, neither swimming nor boating enjoyment are possible. Write this ranking on your field sheet, and you've completed this step of your monitoring. Having recorded the physical condition and recreational suitability of your lake, you're ready to take a transparency reading using your Secchi disc. Again, you don't want to wear sunglasses during this procedure because it will affect the accuracy of the visual readings. If you have photo gradient prescription lenses, you can wear a wide-brimmed hat to keep them from darkening. Lower your Secchi disc into the water until it just disappears from sight. Make a mental note of the depth where the disc disappeared. Now, lower the Secchi disc a bit more and raise it until it just reappears. Again, make a mental note of the depth where the disc reappeared. Now, pull in your Secchi disc. Write down the average of the two depths you noted in the box labeled Secchi disc. And that's it. You've finished the basic lake monitoring using a Secchi disc reading. You'll repeat this procedure each time you monitor your lake over the summer. If you are participating in the Advanced Lake Monitoring Program, then you should watch the next section of this presentation to see the additional sampling you'll be doing.